many businesses only accepting credit cards as forms of payment nowadays. You can imagine identity thieves are out on the prowl. The Federal Trade Commission's Consumer Sentinel Network has reported nearly 56,000 identity theft cases in Texas, and credit card fraud tops that list. Michelle Mills with the BBB is here this morning to tell us about how these scams work and what you can do to keep from becoming a victim. Thank you so much for joining us, Michelle.
Thank you. Good morning.
Good morning. So how exactly do these scams work?
So with enough information, and they can get it from various entry points, it could come in through online shopping, just getting on a website and them gathering information through social media, through a phone call, through mail. They can even go through your garbage. These identity thieves can get this information and commit all kinds of crimes. They can create applications for credit cards, for loans. They can withdraw money. They can, of course, charge things. And then they can also sell that information to others. And it can take a long time to detect, because typically when they do something like that, they're going to make sure that those bills and statements don't go to your address. So it may be a while, if you're not looking, it may be a while for you to know that you actually have become victimized. So prevention is really, really key here.
So obviously we can tell if this has happened to us if we start seeing some random charges that we know definitely we did not make. But how else can we tell if our information has been compromised?
Well, you just really have to be proactive in looking for false information. So you do want to make sure that you are reviewing your financial statements and your bank accounts on a regular basis, and checking up on those and calling about those. Because if you catch it early, you can prevent future charges from being associated, and you can dispute charges, of course. The other thing that you can do is make sure if you start getting debt collector calls and you know that they're false, you need to go ahead and check your statements and your credit report. So you can go to annualcreditreport.com and check your credit report for free. I believe once a quarter on that website. You can't get your score, but you can see if there's some fraudulent things on there.
So what else can we do to keep from being a victim?
Well, you need to protect yourself from hackers, and one of the main ways you can do that is you can use strong passwords, and I cannot emphasize that enough. Too often, people are using the same password for every single website, so if a hacker gets that one password, they have access to all of your accounts. So I know it seems like a hard thing to remember, but if you can keep maybe even a base password and then something that would identify it with that particular account or website, and add that to it, either at the front or the end or the middle of that password, that might be an easier way for you to remember that password. But use a strong password. The longer the better. Don't use things like your mother's maiden name or 123456 or password or password spelled backwards, that type of thing. Those are really, really common passwords. So you will want to make it hard for these hackers. And then you want to secure your personal documents at home. If you have a roommate, or if you have people that are coming into your home, you want to make sure anything that has that personally identifiable information locked up so that they can't access it, they can't see it. Again, make it difficult for these scammers. And then you want to be on the lookout for phishing scams. Again, protect that personal information. Be very, very suspicious of unsolicited communications, phone calls, emails, text messages, that type of thing, that are asking for your personal or your account information. And then, of course, you want to safely dispose of those sensitive documents. And we just held a shred day here in Tyler this last weekend, and shredded over 33,000 pounds of documents. So we're going to have another one coming up here in Jacksonville. So if you missed that one, you can see us in August in Jacksonville.
That's great, Michelle. Now, also, this is something I was kind of shocked to learn about. You know those fun quizzes on Facebook that says, you know, which Harry Potter character are you? When you agree to do those, I was so surprised about how much they're willing that you're giving permission to, you know, because you can use your
sure.
Facebook account, right, as an easy login for, let's say, Starbucks, and then your credit card's linked to that.
Mm-hmm.
I think I had like 97 of those quiz things. So you just have to read those terms and conditions.
That's right. Read those terms and conditions. And then also, you know, there are lots of posts out there, like asking you to post your birth date and things like that, or things that are personal about you. This information is stuff that scammers can use to help find out your passwords.
Great tips right there. Michelle, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.